$25,150, and for year, or for 2023, $26,150. This other $3,000, GASB 83 is a new rule that I think Kelly explained in the packet. That we're viewing the $3,000, well, we don't have much choice in it, but we view it as not to exceed. It could be less.
And what is it?
It's a new set of county laws that have to be put into place, which will require a lot more time.
Oh.
So,
for the audit.
How much time it's going to take?
Another unfunded, right, funded mandate.
Exactly.
Yes, yeah. Other thing we have, no choice on.
So moved,
okay.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Trustees George Duberstein.
Aye.
Kreis.
Aye.
Kobel.
Aye.
Dernowski.
Aye.
George Ann Duberstein.
Aye.
And Schnellis.
Aye.
Need a motion?
Motion carried.
I'm sorry, Kelly. Need a motion to approve the Mayor's Monarch Pledge Proclamation.
So moved.
Second.
George and John. Discussion? Roll call.
Trustees George Duberstein.
Aye.
Kreis.
Aye.
Kobel.
Aye.
Dernowski.
Aye.
George Ann Duberstein.
Aye.
And Schnellis.
Aye.
Motion carried.
I believe I know the answer to this. Anybody need a break before we go into this next discussion? Okay. John? Kelly?
Okay. So, one thing I'm going to ask is if you have specific line item questions, that you not only provide the page number on here, but the line item number. So for instance, if I was questioning line item one on page one, I would say I'm questioning line item one on page one, 301.000, this way we can all find it easily.
Okay.
So do you wanna talk about the top sheet? Anybody have any specific questions before we go into discussion about the top sheet and everything?
Discussion of the what?
This.
Oh. No, I had a question and I got an answer.
Anyone? Bueller? Okay. So, anybody have any questions about the numbers on the top with the difference and the and everything else, the capital fund, the enterprise fund, any questions on that? Because we're going to review the notes. Now, we have three rounds of budget cuts. The cuts themselves total $576,063. The general admin, general street, enterprise water funds have a 5% contingency built into the budgets. The general fund has the amount of $75,162. To be transferred to the capital reserve account. It was previously decided that each year 50% of anticipated cell tower revenue would be transferred into the general reserve.
Excuse me a second, John.
Yeah.
Something to recognize about that money, that $75,000, is that transfers from one of our buckets into our another bucket, but it counts as an expenditure. We're just taking it from one account, putting it into another account, but it isn't as if the money goes away. But it counts on this sheet as an expenditure, so it, I'm not going to say artificially, but it would add to what originally looked like a loss. Thank you.
A couple of things, I'm not going to read everything because today's I've had all of these for a little bit. A couple of things I would like to point out is that instead of using water to balance our budget this year, we are playing the possibility of using our CD money, because as you noted earlier, our CDs are getting buckets for percentage, so rather than use money out of our enterprise fund, we are going to be using our CD revenue if needed to balance the shortfall for the $479,531. We have more than enough money in CD money to cover that. So we can still come in with a balanced budget. If needed, we will touch that money. We're still not sure how much money we're gonna have on spent funds from this budget fiscal year. We may not need to touch that at all. Just seeing, yeah. What kind of, go ahead. Mike.
That might be a little.
Mike.
When you're saying about taking the money from the water fund.
In previous years, we have taken monies out of, from the.
Water reserve.
I know, I know.
Okay.
But since we've been giving water credits, does that mean that we have less, we have less money in that pot than?
We have more money than we need in the water reserve.
I know, but.
We would have had more money if we did not give the rebate.
In the water enterprise fund portion.
I am very uncomfortable taking money out of the water fund and using it as general.
We're not doing that.
I know, you're not doing it this year, but it has been done in the past, and I really strongly.
In some of the years past, Georgiana, we used that money to do that channelization. We used, for the past 2 or 3 years, because of the project, we were shortfall that. We said, we're gonna take this out of the water fund to do those projects only. And like the rest was like for CDs, we were gonna cash in.
Yeah, we weren't taking money and going out of the pot.
Right.
No, but it was my understanding it just went in the general fund, but you're saying that it was a specific project.
Specific, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, it was specifically for water projects.
Fine, I'm comfortable with that, then. Thank you.
You had, you're moving that hand, George, what do you got?
No.
Oh, okay, it looked like you were just waving.
No, no.
Anything else, Sean?
Any, I have nothing.
Kelly, anything to add?
I mean, I just wanted to say, it took a lot of us to go through this budget many, many times. We always start with a zero budget. We're not saying, you got 20,000 in your account, you got 50,000 in your account. We say, start at zero, really look at what you expended, look what's coming up, look at all the maintenance items that need to be done. And, you know, I appreciate Wally and Mike's time and all his, the mayor's time and all his, Kathy, Roseanne helped me with some of the internal stuff, John and Mary's time, George, yours, Jack. Any input? But it's been a long process, it's been a good process. Anytime we needed to say, okay, we got this, this is where we're at, there was no questions asked. Yes, this was a wish list item, let's cut that, we don't need it. And we put it together again, and so I truly feel this is a really good budget. There's a lot of items that need to get done. The village has resources in the reserves, in the CDs to help cover these items. And we can keep moving the village forward with these items.
Appreciate the hard work that you guys do. Wally, I just have a question. Since Rick was talking about.
Mike, you are hard to hear, Georgiana.
Can't believe that I gave you the voice, George, you couldn't imagine that I had anything. Wally, when Rick was talking about, you know, that our, the mechanics of our well houses are over 20 years old, and, you know, maybe we need to take them out and refurbish them or whatever. Is that something that's in this budget or you're thinking about for soon, I mean, in the next?
Nothing so far this year. But we're probably looking at, you know, the well houses, whether we're gonna build a new one or not.
Probably.
To relieve it, because to rebuild it right now, you have to take one down.
Right.
And you don't wanna do that.
Here's something that is in the budget, it is gonna happen.
Yeah.
We gotta remember, we have the sanitary lift stations, they are gonna be inspected and reviewed this year. A study, both of them. And then I'm expecting something out of that to say, you know, next year we ought to do this to that. I'm tentatively up here thinking that we will evaluate the wells next year.
Because you realize that the reason we set up that water fund in the first place was to do exactly what you're talking about.
Yes, yes.
And if we take all those ones out for now, we wouldn't have any.
No, I mean.
We don't wanna bring them else. But getting back to you, Georgiana, there is some money in the budget which would be to refurbish the water tower and the 90,000 gallon reserve tank we have in there. There's some repairs that we've done for 78,000.
Yeah, it was inspected last year.
Right.
Robinson gave us a report. The not upgrading, but the repairs of it will be in this budget, are in this budget, are in this budget, yes.
So when we get our new well, then you'll be able to refurbish the, take one of them offline and, trade the barn that was off.
Both of these wells, houses actually run a little bit different than what it is. I was thinking about all this and not everybody knows how these wells work.
We don't have to go through this whole thing right now, but.
Okay.
Give them a refresh.
Yeah.
What's on this, right, and there's one over in Holiday Lane somewhere?
Yes.
I don't wanna go too far afield.
No, but this is what happened when I was thinking about if we're gonna try to explain what's going on, what we did to the well houses, why we're trying to fix money and this and that, okay? So, I just started out, I just said, well, I'm just draw a flow chart of what really happens here, okay? And if you look at this, I've got a water tower on the top, okay? And then you see in the dotted line, first dotted line, is well house number one. Well house number one has all basically the controls for the well, for the water tower, and it controls the well pumps in well house one, and also well house three, and it also, now well house one has booster pumps. And the reason it has booster pumps, besides for a well pump, okay, is the fact that we have the 9,000 gallon reserve tank. So it has to take, draw the water out of it, and that's what the booster pumps are for, and then it sends it up to the water tower. Well house three has a well pump, okay? Which is down about, and the yellow, when you look at the yellow, it didn't show up very well. Those are the pump controllers. That's what he was talking about, the magnetics, the starters for the motors and everything else. Most of those have gone to variable speed drives. If you keep on here, you say variable speed drives, which is VFDs, okay? Variable frequency drivers, I should say, okay? And that takes care of a lot of these starters and contactors. They don't slap the pumps. They actually ramp them up nice and slowly, and then all of a sudden it gets up to full speed, and that's what we do. So that's the upgrades that I've been thinking about when I've talked to Jerry about stuff like that. Also, so what you see here is it's kind of a flow chart of how all that works. So if you look at well house number one, there's a lot of different major things there that you have to spend money on, and that's awesome. So,
okay. We're thank you, sir. If you have any questions about that, feel free to call Wally, yeah. Or I've got a fairly good understanding of it. Budget questions, comments. This is discussion only tonight, so.
Well done, everybody.
Good job.
Thank you. Kelly, next steps.
I'm going to look at the calendar and see if we have to hold the appropriations hearing and then the passage. We can make amendments and changes on this document up until after the appropriation hearing. So it'll either be the March or the April meeting, but I'll get all the information and get that going.
Can you do a good visit tonight?
We have legally until 3 months into the new fiscal year. We generally like to have it approved by the April meeting, so that way May 1st we're up and running and going. So you still have plenty of time to look through. If you have any questions, Georgianne, she emailed me a question and I answered it. If I can't get the right answer, I hear whoever can help her.
All right, thank you all for your patience. I know this is one of our longer meetings. I hope I can keep them short from here on out. I appreciate your input. And as usual, if you have any questions or comments, make sure you let me know. Motion to adjourn.
No, my honor.
We already passed it.
Okay, I just want to make sure.
Yeah. Some of those things we voted on. Motion to adjourn.
Some of